Cheers, man.
Cheers.
Thank you, Joe. Next up is Jake Bennett, MNR.
Hey, Jake Bennett here with Music News and Rumors. How's it going, Regis?
I'm good, brother. How you doing?
I'm good, thanks. So you've talked before about how it's been a hard road to make it where you are today, and you're an inspiration to a lot of people out there. What do you have to say to your fans who aspire to reach the heights you have in your career?
I mean, as far as for me, bro, I did an interview the other day, like, yeah, I made it, you know, and I had like a long, hard road to get where I'm at, you know. So for what I would tell like upcoming fighters or anybody, you know, just stick with it. You got to be consistent. You definitely got to be consistent. You got to give everything you got. For me, I was like working as a personal trainer for like 6 to 8 years, but I always believed in myself. I always believed in my ability. It was never quit in me, and it was never. I know a lot of athletes and stuff. They'll go to schools and tell kids, you have to have a backup plan. But for me, it was no backup plan. You know, I figured a backup plan after if I have this, if I don't have this, that's when I figure a backup plan. So, I just was all the way invested in my career in boxing. I was all the way invested in boxing all the way, and it wasn't no failing for me. So, you know, that's why I got to where I am today.
All right, great. Thanks very much. Next up is Donna Corby.
Regis, you've fought for so many great promoters on so many great shows in your career. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us a bit about behind the scenes how you're enjoying working with Triller and, I suppose, Ryan Kavanaugh and Snoop Dogg?
Well, it's great, bro. Like, I mean, everything is great. Like, I mean, even like the whole bubble thing going on right now, it's just good. Like, it's just, you know, I fought for a lot of different promotions and all that type of stuff, but this is, you know, I like it. I just like everything that's going on here. I like the promotion. They're running smooth. Everything is good. You know, I can't complain about nothing.
It appears that they've got a lot of people. They've got some good boxing people involved too, but they've taken a lot of people from outside of the world of boxing. You're not seeing any, you're not seeing any Bob Arum here. You're not seeing any Lou DiBella here. It's sort of new people mm-hmm. to the space. Do you think the boxing kind of needed that from a new big promoter at some point?
Yeah, I definitely think so. I don't want to talk shit about Bob Arum and Lou DiBella. Of course, don't get me on
no,
that.
No, of course,
pad,
I'm.
You know,
yeah, those are examples,
yeah,
I'm giving.
It's always good to bring in new people, right? It's always good to bring in like new faces and just new ideas. And like I said, with this whole Triller thing going on, it's a great thing that we got this stuff going on, because it's new ideas, and you're bringing in new fans. You know, you can't keep doing the same old thing. The world is ever changing. You got to change with the world. So, and I'm loving every second of this.
If you were to speak to people who were at the sports book this weekend gambling on your fight, what would you tell them to bet on?
I would tell them, don't bet on me, because you're not going to, you know, I would say don't bet, because I'm going to fuck them up anyway. Well, you know what I'm saying? In the eyes of fucking crazy, you know, I don't bet. I'm not a betting person. But if you, a lot of people saying all kinds of stuff, under one, under two, under three, all that. I just go out there and do what I gotta do. I don't worry about no bets and all that stuff. You know, some people they get in your, not get in your head, but they're like, all my neighbors and stuff, they'll tell me, yeah, I'm betting and I'm gonna bet this. I'm bet like, bro, like, leave me alone. Like, I'm gonna go out there and do my thing. You know, that's what I'm gonna do.
What's the biggest one you've heard of? What's the biggest bet you've heard somebody making on you?
I think like shit, one round or something like that. Somebody, I mean, as far as money wise, I don't know, but you know, like they'll say like one round or something. Like, bro, like leave me alone, bro. Like, I'm not worried about that. Like, I'm gonna go out there and do me. I'm not worried about, you know, I'm prepared for, I think we're doing 10 rounds. I'm prepared for 10 rounds. I'm not worried about none of the other stuff.
Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you, Donna. And thank you, Regis. We're clear.
Cool.
Appreciate
perfect.
It.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right, everyone, at the bottom of the hour, we'll have Jake at the bottom of the hour or whenever he's here. So it might be before that, whenever he comes in. But just stay tuned. We'll be right back with you.